There's something we're gonna wanna consider for this project, and that is the type of business that we're in as a remodeling contractor. So there's this economic classification of products and services. I'm just gonna call these goods for simplicity's sake for this lesson, even though that's not entirely accurate in our case. So anyway, this classification is SEC, which stands for Search, Experience, and Credence. And these classifications are based on how easy it is for a consumer or the buyer of a good, a product or service, to evaluate or to get information about that good. And so a search good, the S in SEC, is one where that good can easily be evaluated by the purchaser before it's purchased. Now these tend to be simple products, often commodities. So one example might be clothing. If you head down to your favorite clothing retailer to buy a new shirt, you can pick that shirt up, you can inspect the stitching and the material, you can go and try it on and see how it fits. You know what color it is, you know if it has sleeves or buttons or zippers or whatever. You can get all this information pretty easily and quickly just by looking at the shirt. It's fairly simple to evaluate a shirt. Now, I'm sure we've all had that experience of taking home a piece of clothing, wearing it for a while and deciding we don't actually like it for some reason, and we just didn't notice or think of that reason before we purchased it. But for the most part, you can evaluate pretty much everything about a shirt before you buy it. And it's fairly simple. You just go to the store, you look at it, you try it on. And this is the key differentiator of a search good. You don't have to buy the shirt first before you have most of the information you need to evaluate it. You can evaluate it almost entirely before you make the purchase. So let's contrast that with an experience good. Now, an experience good is one that you cannot easily evaluate until after you've already purchased it. Now, one way I remember this is to think of an experience good as something you have to experience first before you can evaluate it. So a restaurant is a great example of an experience good. You can't easily tell if it's a good restaurant until you eat there. So you have to go experience it first. Other examples would be hotels, hairdressers, theme parks, vacation destinations, movies, anything you have to buy first, then evaluate second, falls into this category. Okay, so the next category, the C in SEC, are credence goods. Now, credence goods are interesting because credence goods are impossible to evaluate even after you've purchased them. Now, that sounds crazy, right? What can we not properly evaluate after the fact? Well, lots of stuff, it turns out. Lots of B2B stuff falls into this category. A lot of services fall into this category. So take legal services, for example. Let's say you hire an attorney to write some business contracts. The attorney writes your contracts, you pay the attorney, and then you have the contracts. But not being an attorney well-versed in contract law yourself, do you have any real ability to evaluate how good those contracts are? Like, how well will they hold up in court? Are the clauses even legal? Was there anything major that the attorney missed? You can't possibly know that stuff before you've purchased the contracts, but you also can't know that stuff even after you've purchased the contracts because, well, you're not an attorney. That's why you hired an attorney in the first place. Lots of stuff falls into this category. Legal services, accounting services, marketing services, medical services, so like doctors and hospitals. Lots of stuff falls into this category because it's based primarily on how difficult it is to find the information you would need to evaluate the good before and even after the purchase. So if you can easily get most of what you'd need to evaluate the good before you buy it, then it's a search good. If you have to buy it first before you have that information, then it's an experience good. And if you won't know before or after you buy it, then it's a credence good. Now, this SEC classification is typically viewed in a spectrum, but for the most part, as a remodeling contractor, we provide a credence service. It sort of depends on the exact service being provided, the exact scope of work. Like, is this entirely a design project or an architecture or engineering or construction, or are we just doing the flooring or cabinets or something like that? But if you're hiring us to do this work, you're probably not going to know for sure whether we're good at what we do even after you hire us. Yeah, you can evaluate how smoothly the process went or how much it sounds like we know our stuff. You can evaluate if the design met your personal subjective opinion of what is good or bad design. But if we tell you, for example, to use bamboo versus oak for your floors, are you really gonna know if that's actually a good idea or if we're just trying to maximize our profit? Will you know if the chemical composition of the concrete we poured was adequate for your foundation work? What about the waterproofing? Did we do it the best way, the cheapest way, or the most common way? Those all might be a little different. Unless you really know your stuff, you probably are not gonna be able to evaluate most of this before or after the fact. So there's a major information information asymmetry here. Us, as the remodeling company, we know way more about this, and it would be hard for a customer to get all the info they need to fully evaluate everything we did even after we did it. Now, building regulations and inspections and things like that can help to level out this information asymmetry a bit, and that's really what their purpose is, but there's still a pretty big asymmetry. And because of that, the interesting thing about Credence goods is that they tend to be evaluated on things that don't actually even indicate quality at all. Instead, they're evaluated on other, more available information that the consumer or the buyer does have access to. So, for example, hospital patients have been shown to accurately report information on whether a physician was respectful, attentive, clear in explaining clinical issues, and operated a clean and efficient office. These same patients were found to be inaccurate in reporting on the technical quality of the care that they received. And those other things they did use to evaluate the physician, the cleanliness of the office, how respectful they were, stuff like that, those things were not even highly correlated with the technical aspects of quality care. And what's wild is this happens even when quality metrics about physicians are available. People just ignore them or don't trust them. So Credence goods are typically not judged by their quality as much as by other more easily available information. And so the things that tend to convince customers to purchase a Credence product or service are things other than the technical quality of the work. So what kind of things are those? These are typically things like expert third-party reviews and opinions. These tend to be weighted much more heavily than customer reviews or opinions. Prestige signals like winning remodeling or design awards, in our case, being mentioned in major publications like design magazines or on TV or mentioned by well-known influencers. Being on TV as an expert commentator, like on the news or something like that, talking about the home building industry. Authority signals will help here too. So being elected to the local Builders Association board or something like that. And then I bet the subjective sort of wow factor in our project portfolio or the website as a whole will come into play a little bit here as well for this particular project. Other things are going to matter during the project, like how well we communicated, our ability to manage the project and hit deadlines, stuff like that. But that stuff isn't available until after the purchase for the most part. So it won't really sell new clients on why we're awesome. Now, we obviously have to know what we're doing and we have to do decent work, but all these other things are really gonna have a much bigger impact on new customer acquisition and evaluation by existing customers than the technical quality of our work. That just has to be pretty good. It's got to be above some standard. All right, so there's something we should really talk about at this point. Notice that none of those things have anything to do with getting ranked in search. So if we spend all our marketing and PR budget as a remodeling contractor trying to get ranked in search, and we don't spend time and effort lining up all those other quality indicators, we probably won't drive much business even if we do get ranked. Now, what'll actually happen is our user behavior signals will probably be bad enough that without all those other Credence indicators of quality, then we probably won't get ranked anyway unless we're just like significantly larger or more well-known than everybody else or something like that. But this is a really common mistake we see businesses make a lot. They think getting ranked is all they need to do to drive business. And if you're on the search side of the SEC continuum, then yeah, increasing visibility alone will probably have a big impact on revenue. Just getting your name out there, getting found, is gonna have a huge impact. But as you move more into the experience goods, visibility will still be crucial, but it's not gonna be all you need. And the closer you get to the Credence side of the continuum here, you'll start to have a really hard time driving more business just with increased search visibility. So this fact that we're a Credence service will factor into our overall marketing strategy, our overall SEO strategy. Now, of course, if we're mid-market in this space, it's highly likely that we have already done a lot of this stuff, but it would be a huge mistake for a brand new company in this space to go after SEO before they have all those expert reviews and awards and major PR wins and stuff like that.